we were talking with Major. Major mentioned a whole lot of things that can help people out. Number one thing, the biggest psychological factor of sticking to your own dream. So when I would talk, only stylish so I want. Like to be stylish, so na ubola yana sa vidwaga, and ubaila wat play difanda, ga chelete yana sa wabona fana. So what can you say to someone who's new on trail, and what can be the biggest thing that you want them to focus on for them to basically grow? At least something that someone can take and say, I learned this from tonight's life, that from here, I'm going to go home and implement this and basically be a better thing.
This is what I was saying, eh, to the guys earlier on. Obviously, we're planning on having
a
Bro, you know my guy. So this is what I was saying, obviously, to the guys today that we were having that meeting with. Yeah. Number one, we are not here to eat off from the people that are trying to make it also in the game. Obviously, we are here to inspire people, you know. Okay, the background music is distracting us. Let me try tone it down. Let me try turning it down, baby. Until you listen, man. Ubukela ma idols, but the people are complaining. They're saying it's making noise. Let me put the phone on the charge. It's low. It's been updating the whole team. Yeah. So, number one point. We are not in this game to eat off from the people that are also trying to make it in the game, right? Mm-hmm. Secondly, we wanna inspire a black child. We wanna inspire someone that wants to make it out there, obviously. So the first thing that I said to the gents today with regards to trading NAS 100 is very easy. So it's a game of emotions. Anyone can analyze Nasdaq. I just saw quite a number of people have sent their analysis on the live and stuff like that and everything.
Yeah.
So if you trade NAS 100 and you miss an entry, you shouldn't chase for that entry. That's the first thing. This is the psychology of being a successful NAS 100 trade. If you miss an entry, you shouldn't chase the entry. It's gone. If you miss Nasdaq at your support, it's gone. If you miss Nasdaq at your resistance, it's gone. So the minute you start going to M1 looking for an entry, that's where you know you've got it wrong. The minute you start going to M5 looking for an entry, that's the minute you know you've got it wrong. That's where the blowing comes in. That's where the losing of money comes in. So Nasdaq requires a lot of discipline. It requires a lot of psychological discipline, controlling your emotions. There's a lot of money nested, and there's a lot of positive money also. You can also experience a lot of negative money also. That means you can make a lot of money and you can also lose the same amount of money that you would make in Nasdaq. Nasdaq requires a lot of discipline. That is the art of mastering Nasdaq. Anyone can analyze Nasdaq. I was saying to you, boy, Uguti, sometimes you want to draw a line and I'll start to trade. Best trade will hambe in a line. This is a little shy TP, good arrow, I draw a line. Do you understand me? Yeah. So sometimes people analyze and then the trade just goes and hit TP with that arrow that they drew. They didn't take the trade because they were afraid, number one. Number two, because they missed it. So if you missed the trade, it's fine. Let the trade go. If you missed the trade, it's fine. It's okay. You'll find another trade. The market is a repetitious cycle. So what happens today happened last week. It happened last year. It happened last month. So the market always gives you these things. Gives you a repetitious cycle. It bounces off its support. Next year, it will do the same thing. It can't change because you are starting to trade today. So if you missed the trade, don't rush for an entry. Don't go for another entry. Looking for an entry at M1, and then you draw a ridiculous support and resistance levels on your smaller time frames. So if you miss an entry, it's gone. It's gone. It's gone. Yeah. You know, it's the same with anything else that is to trade out there. You know, So if let's say someone out there is asking themselves, what am I doing wrong? What did I do wrong on this trade? Sometimes you miss a trade at entry, and then you catch it along the way. It comes and retests your support again, and then it buys. You know. So I was saying, it's better to blow an account because it went against your analysis than blowing an account because you caught it late.
Mm.
You get it. So you can't say the people that are on my signals group know. I don't give out Nasdaq signals as much as I give out other currency pairs, whatever the case. I probably give out 2 signals for Nasdaq a day. And per 0.01, I don't close 400 on 0.01. I don't close 200 on a 0.01. I close serious money on a 0.01. I close about 1,000 rand, 2,000 on a 0.01. You know why? Because I catch it at support, I let it go to resistance. That is how I trade, higher time frame. And number one, if you have 10,000 rands that you are trading on Nasdaq, and you are saying, I'm willing to lose 2,000 on this trade, you withdraw the 8,000 and put it aside, and you trade the 2,000 that you are willing to lose. Obviously, you have your levels marked up, you have your zones marked up, support and resistance and all of that. Once the market touches support, you don't buy when it touches support. You wait for confirmation, because no one said the market will reverse at support or it will buy from support. They can easily break that level and go the opposite direction. It's very possible with Forex, you know, with anything that is to trade out there, including VIX, including boom and crash, including everything. So you wait for confirmation at your zones, and then that's where you enter. So as a Nasdaq trader, you always need to be on your chart. You always need to be hands-on when it comes to your chart work. You know, you put in the time, you put in the work, you put in the energy. Believe it or not, it's very much possible to master Nasdaq. You know, boy, it's very much possible. You can't lose when you are following up on your work. You know, you have your markups nicely marked up, and you wait for confirmations. You don't buy. So there's certain patterns and certain confirmations that I personally look out for, that I'm teaching my mentees, that I mentor, for them to also look out for them, because I can't win alone. When you are my mentee, you also need to win the same way that I win. You know, you can't lose when I'm winning. That means me being a mentor to you is in vain. You know, if I'm winning, you also need to win. So that comes with discipline. Number one, dog. The reason why I'm starting to see consistency in my trading career is because it is only now that I'm applying discipline. It is only now that I'm applying discipline. So if number one, discipline comes in two ways.
Yeah.
Discipline comes in two ways. So there's discipline of entering a trade, and there's discipline of leaving a trade. So you were talking about daily targets earlier on. Né? So if you are a trader, obviously you have daily targets. You calculate your expenses for the month. You calculate your expenses for the week. You calculate your expenses for the day. You have your daily targets. If you are targeting 2,000 rands a day and you are holding a trade, once it gets to 2,000 rands, that is when you discipline yourself to exit the trade. You don't hold the trade when you've reached your daily target. That is where the greed comes in. And remember, greed is an enemy of success. Once the greed starts creeping in, boy, then success is an enemy to you. So if you are greedy, you are an enemy to success. You and success cannot be spoken about in the same sentence when you are greedy. So if you have daily targets, you close. Once you see 2,000, you close. 2,045 rand, you close. 2,100, you close. 2,045 cents, you close. Because that is your daily discipline. You know, your daily target is reached. You forget about the charts. Sometimes it happens that the market just shoots up and you see 5,000 and your target was 2,000. It's fine. You close the 5,000. That means you are what? You are a day ahead. So tomorrow you are trading and you have floating 2,000 that was unplanned. You know, so you are sticking to your trading plan. Remember, you just made 5,000 unexpected. And then now this means that you are 2 days ahead. You have today's profit and you have tomorrow's profit. So it's all upon you. If you are trading the next day, you are trading with one day ahead. That is when success is sped up, you know. And then the following day, you see that, I know I'm not feeling like trading today. You don't trade. But if you trade, you know that I've already secured then the following day. And the other day, you blow 2,000. So in your trading plan, you are still fine because in 5 days, you've made 12,000 when you had planned to make 10,000. So you've made 12,000, and the 2,000 that you blew is out of your plan.